There are plenty of objects that are good at blocking light and casting shadows. Clouds, trees, birds, people, the moon. But what about light itself? Can photons cast shadows? At first glance, the answer appears to be no. Light, or photons, are electromagnetic waves, and electromagnetic waves can't directly interact with themselves. Other waves in nature, waves in shallow water, for example, can bounce directly off of or at least influence each other, but not photons. They just pass right through. That's why sunlight doesn't block cell phone signals, or human vision. However, there are three indirect ways that photons can interact with other photons. First, if a photon bumps into, say, an electron, and that electron bumps into another photon, the photons will technically have redirected each other. But this requires an electron to be in just the right place at the right time, so I don't think it really counts as a way for a photon by itself to make a shadow. Second, just like how photons passing close to massive objects like the sun or a black hole follow paths curved by gravity, a photon itself has energy and momentum and would technically gravitationally attract another passing photon. But the gravity from a photon is ridiculously tiny. Even the most energetic photon we've ever measured had a smaller gravitational field than a strand of DNA, which won't allow a photon to make a noticeable shadow. But, third and finally, super high energy photons can spontaneously turn into particle-antiparticle pairs, like an electron and a positron, and then back again. And these particles can deflect other photons, resulting in legit photon-on-photon scattering. I say legit because the key here is that you don't need to luck out and have an electron happen to be passing by. Two solitary high-energy photons can spontaneously generate their own means of crashing into or bouncing off of each other. So what kind of shadow do we get? Well, photons only bounce off each other exceedingly rarely. Even very, very carefully controlled experiments with ridiculously high-powered lasers have a hard time observing any interaction between photons, which doesn't sound promising for noticing a shadow. But there is one very real way that photons cast shadows. Because space is so huge, super high-energy photons traveling through it do eventually crash into one of the many low-energy photons of the cosmic microwave background radiation that are present pretty much everywhere in the universe. And so, right now, you are literally being shadowed from ultra-high-energy gamma-ray photons by the photons left over from the Big Bang. Alright, it's sponsor time, which means Particle Fever promotion time. I've recommended it before because it's an amazing documentary about particle physics, and I'm gonna recommend it again because I know not all of you have watched it on CuriosityStream yet. Otherwise, why would they still be sponsoring Minute Physics videos? Anyway, in addition to Particle Fever, CuriosityStream has a deal going on right now. If you get a CuriosityStream subscription, which costs less than a cup of coffee, you now also get a bundled subscription to Nebula, the streaming service made by and for educational YouTube video creators, with ad-free viewing and exclusive originals like Real Engineering's series on the insane logistics of D-Day. So, go to curiositystream.com/minutephysics and use offer code MINUTEPHYSICS to get your first month of CuriosityStream and Nebula for free. Just think how many times you can watch Particle Fever in a month.